I'm so happy to finally be back. And looking around, I'm not alone in that sentiment either. Maybe it won't last, but everyone's determined to enjoy it to the fullest while they can. After all, who knows what tomorrow will bring? I knew things wouldn't instantly go back to normal, but I didn't expect all that to be thrown on us.
Want us to help liberate the capital?
With Ruhr and Bereahard silent, we have a firm foothold to take back Heimdall. If we don't seize the moment before the year is up, there's every chance the war will drag on even longer as a result.
Fighting is still brutal as ever in Western Erebonia. But if the Nortia and Kreutzen provincial armies keep their word not to interfere, be able to turn the war around.
That does sound like the best chance we'll ever get, but I still have doubts.
I've said it before, and I'll say it again. We have no intention of taking an active role in the war.
We simply wish to fulfill our duties as Military Academy students.
That sounds perfectly fine to me.
We aren't asking you to fight on the front lines to retake the city. Rather, we would like you, the students of Thor's Military Academy, to liberate one very specific location.
Yeah?
And where might that be?
I'll be the one explaining that. You're here too?
You're from the Intelligence Division.
Huh. Hi, Elector. Long time no see. You back from Crossbell?
Yep. The most pressing problem over there is all taken care of now. So, I was finally able to access the Intelligence Division's network again.
Wait a second. Most pressing problem? What happened over there?
Oh, you know, that Azure tree is gone. There was a ton of confusion after its disappearance. But President Kreuz has been arrested, and things are beginning to calm down.
We had no idea.
I remember feeling an incredible amount of mana from that tree.
Whatever happened there, it's obvious Ouroboros was involved.
Regardless of how it came to happen, the fact remains, Crossbell is of no danger to us now. Yet with that, comes new dangers on the horizon.
What do you mean, Dad?
Now that Crossbell is no longer a threat, there's every chance the Calvert Republic might make a move, is that correct?
The Republic still has its own share of chaos as a result of their economic crisis and terrorism. But now that there's an opening to take Crossbell, we've no doubt they will recover sooner rather than later.
And without Gorillia Fortress to serve as an effective deterrent, there's always the possibility they could use Crossbell as a staging area to launch a military incursion into Erebonia.
As a result, our primary concern is ending this war as soon as possible. Could use your assistance in bringing it to an ever swifter conclusion.
I understand the situation.
In that case, where is this specific location that you'd like us to liberate?
That would be the Corell Imperial Villa.
Hey, isn't that...
That's the Imperial family's villa on the outskirts of the city, right?
Are you suggesting that my family is at the villa?
We believe your assumption to be correct, Your Highness. The Intelligence Division has established that His Imperial Majesty and the rest of your family have been imprisoned there. Lady Elise Schwarzer and Imperial Governor Regnitz are also with them.
Dad's there too? They've been there this whole time?
It's close to the capital, but it's surrounded on all sides by cliffs and the like. That makes it the perfect place to keep VIPs hidden away.
Exactly. The only way to access it via land is a special train that runs from Heimdall Station. And that is currently heavily secured by the Imperial Guard. However, were your party to use the Courageous to fly there, you should be able to get inside.
I think you already know our answer.
Yeah, I'm in.
If you say they're there, Lecter, then they're there.
It's not much different from liberating Ruhr or the Twin Dragons Bridge, if we think of it like rescuing someone related to us.
Indeed. While the Imperial family is naturally of great importance, rescuing a member of the Board of Directors fits our motives to a T.
And we've always seen it as our duty to help those related to the Academy.
Guess that settles that.
Thank you. I truly appreciate it.
Well, aren't we being humble?
This is what friends do.
To think these kids would turn out to be so dependable.
You're telling me. They're almost dazzling.
Your Highness, may we have your permission to move forward? By all means. I, Alfin Rysay Arnor, humbly request that you carry out this mission.
Very well, Your Highness.
Students of Thor's Military Academy, I hereby declare that we shall dedicate our all to the liberation of the Corel Imperial Villa.
Really is strange. For all I know, tomorrow could determine the outcome of this war. And yet I feel completely at peace. Just being back here, seeing the sky, and being surrounded by this cool air makes me feel so happy. Why?
You're not planning on standing here alone the whole night, are you?
Oh, hey, Celine. Where's Emma?
Who knows? I'm guessing she's over in the Literature Club's room. One of the second years dragged her off. Something about checking if any of her precious book collection had vanished.
That would be Dorothy. I don't know. I could wander around, but my head's kind of full at the moment. It's like it's suddenly registering just how much this academy means to me. I knew I liked it, but never realized how much.
Oh? Well, whatever you end up doing tonight, make it count. With both Vita and Ouroboros involved, you haven't seen the worst this war has to offer. The hardest part's yet to come. And you don't want to face your friend in the goofy bandana weighed down by regrets, do you?
True enough. Oh, hey, are you here because you were worried about me? You've always been so considerate of us, even if you do try to hide it by acting grumpy half the time.
Stop that! You can't go around being nice to every girl you run into. Try treating someone special for once. Surely there's someone who fits that description better than me.
Someone special, huh?
This could be the last night you have to enjoy before everything goes to hell. Go and walk around a bit already. Oh, and go pay Valimar a visit, too. Honestly, anyone with half a brain could have figured that out. Why do I have to be the one to tell you?
I suppose she's right. It seems a shame to waste a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity standing around here alone. It's been a long time since I was last here at the Academy. I should walk around and see everyone. I've got a lot of catching up to do with the people in Trista. And after Valimar offered to stand guard near the west exit, it wouldn't feel right to leave him by himself the whole night.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, you guys are all up here?
Hi, Ring.
Hey, nice night, isn't it?
It's a little on the chilly side, but it still feels pretty nice since there's no breeze out. Oh yeah, you're right.
finally back here.
Yeah, got to admit, seeing it again's making me feel all emotional.
No doubt. Especially since, unlike the rest of us, you guys were last here during the festival.
You're probably feeling lonely with Crow missing. Toa, George, Angelica, I want to thank you.
Huh?
What for?
You guys have helped us out so much. There's no way we could have gone that far without you. If it were just us first years, I don't think things would have gone half as well. So, on behalf of everyone here, thank you. For everything you've done.
We should be the ones thanking you.
Yeah. Think about all the work Class 7 put into this and try saying that again.
Exactly. You guys even helped me deal with my old man. Where would I be without you?
I guess. But for the record, we've needed you just as much as you say you need us, you know. You shouldered the most responsibility on the Courageous, the ship that carried us and our dreams this far. And I'm gonna need you to keep watching our backs tomorrow. You think you can do that for us?
Like you even had to ask.
We'll be right there with you.
We would never abandon you after we've come this far together.
Thanks. I get this feeling like tomorrow's going to mark a turning point for us. Whether the Imperial Army's operation is a success or a failure, it feels like the time for me to fight Crow is almost here.
That's true.
Yeah, he won't let a chance like this just waltz on by.
And this time, I'm not going to let him win. I'll beat him, drag him right back here, and force him to finally graduate with you.
You sure that's even possible, Rean?
That's not going to be...
I'm well aware that it won't be easy. But everyone, not just me, wants the four of you together again. Class 7 managed to reunite, right? Now it's your turn.
You're amazing, Rean. And if you say that's what you're gonna do, I've got no reason to doubt you. Good luck!
Tomorrow's operation is sounding crazier by the minute.
Seriously. I better hope I can finish polishing off that Tachi. Hey, Valimar.
Hello, Reed.
I came to see how you were holding up. Sure was a surprise when you offered, but thanks for volunteering to serve as a lookout.
Not a problem. Perhaps you and your friends have influenced me to some degree. Each and every one of you have come a long way to take this place back. I simply wish for you to be able to dedicate this evening to celebrating that achievement.
Thanks. You know, looking back, I never figured the day would come when I'd be able to have a natural conversation with you like this. You've changed a lot in that regard. You've gone from sounding mechanical to dignified, I suppose.
I've been working to gradually recover my memories over time. And while still fragmented, I am now able to recollect specific memories from my past.
Really? Does that mean you remember some of what happened before you went to sleep in the old schoolhouse?
Correct. I went to sleep 250 years, 128 days ago. And my previous awakener was a man known as Dreykles Rysay Arner.
Wow. So it really was Dreykles, huh? I had my suspicions when I saw that memory in the last shrine, but I didn't want to assume.
I believe you resonated with the memories that reside within the proving grounds. Dreykles visited the spirit shrines as you did. In each one, he obtained the same ore with which to forge his weapon, advanced upon the same capital. And it was there, with many allies at his side, that he laid the mortal rest in one final confrontation.
It's kind of eerie how similar our paths are. But it makes me feel a little self-conscious, too, in a way. I doubt we're doing all this half as well as he did. What kind of person was he, anyway?
He was an open-minded, composed, and driven man. Full of bravery and daring. And in some ways, an enigma. Yet for those he met, he was ever kind and merciful. He had dignity in measure with his stature, and still at times, one could see in his eyes the glimmer of a child's.
He was really something, wasn't he? Hearing you talk about him, I don't know if I could be anything like he was. But maybe if I were, I'd be able to do more for everyone.
There is little need in striving to be something you are not.
Huh?
Since my awakening, I have watched over you. I have seen you grow as a person. Dreykles found success in playing to his strengths. You, though different, possess strengths no less great. Just as he attracted his own supporters, so too have you gained those who would choose to stand by your side and no other. Take pride in those who become your sword, for not even kings can buy the loyalty you have earned.
Thanks, Valimar. You're right. I should focus on improving myself as I am, rather than try to become someone I'm not. Seeing as how I'm fighting for my future and to bring home my friend, it wouldn't make sense to be anyone else, really. Oh, yeah. It sounds like the Tachi will be done by morning. So if you're up for it, I think we should test it out tomorrow. I'll be counting on you, Valimar.
I shall do all within my power.
Thank you.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Hey, no worries. I haven't been waiting long. Did you take care of everything you wanted to do? Last time I saw you, you were still out in the garden.
Yeah, Adel and I planted some new seeds. I found them myself.
Really? I can't wait to see what they grow into then.
It's kind of nice to be back home, especially after so long.
Yeah, really brings back memories. And now that we're here, why don't we head inside and walk around for a bit? I'm curious to see how things have held up upstairs, too.
Sounds good to me. I wonder if Crow ever plans on coming back to us.
Honestly, I don't think so. Not of his own free will, at least. It's clear that he really believes in what he's doing. I've sworn over and over that we'll bring him back. I don't think that's going to be so easy at this point. But that's never put us off before. We'll get him back no matter what happens.
Yep, we won't lose. Not to Zeno or Leo either.
Having to fight the two of them this way must be tough on you. No one wants to fight family.
Yeah, but that's exactly why I can't hold back against them. If I show them even a hint of hesitation, I'll never be able to get through to them. I think the same's true for Crow, too.
I suppose you're right.
I've always wanted to find a family. Even my earliest memory has me wandering lost on a battlefield, trying to find somewhere I could belong. But eventually, I found one. Zephyr. They gave me a place to call home. Showed me a warmth only a family can provide. And always looked out for me.
A place to call home, huh?
Then we lost our boss. And the family who'd given me all of that decided to leave me behind. And I realized how weak I really was. On my own, I was nothing. I always relied on them to keep me safe. But I couldn't do anything for them in return. After that, Sarah took me in, and I wound up joining Class 7. For the first time in my life, I was around people who needed me just as much as I needed them. For the first time, I could protect them just as much as they protected me. I found myself part of a completely different kind of family. One I didn't even know existed. And I'm so grateful to Class 7, and especially you, for giving me that. I still want to ask them why they all left me behind. But more than that, I want to show off the new family I found. I want them to see how well I'm doing now. Zeno and Leo were always important to me. But that's why I want to let them know just how important all of you are, too.
That's a heck of a compliment. And we'll do everything in our power to make sure you can show us off.
thanks. It's weird. There's all kinds of ways to form a family, right? And it's easy to find where everyone else fits in ours. But you're just kind of different.
In what way?
Elisa, Laura, Emma, and Sarah are like older sisters to me. Milliam's obviously my annoying kid sister. Machias, Eusis, and Gaius are like my big brothers. And so's Crow, I guess. But I don't think of you like that. You're not like a sibling, but something else. Something closer. I can't put it into words, though.
See? I feel the same way about you. You're more than family to me, and I'm glad to have you by my side. You might be a bit younger than most of us, but you fight harder to defend those you love more than anyone I know. And you're every bit as important to me as I am to you, if not more so.
Good.
Anyway, we've got work to do tomorrow. The future of our Class 7 family rests in our hands.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Understood.
Don't you worry. We'll take good care of them.
Just leave them to us.
May Adios and Dreykles the Lionheart be with you all. And please, come back here safe and unharmed. Our objective is to rescue His Majesty the Emperor, as well as those who were captured with him. Everyone, move out!
Understood. Right.